Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be answering a question from Chaz NSC, who asks, newest user here. I use Autodesk Civil 3D daily and I've toyed with SketchUp, but this is a first time doing something official, building a 3D version of a planned amphitheater. I have been tracing the flat plan from AutoCAD and created these three-dimensional shapes. I'd like to trim down the side wall as shown. What's the best method for doing this? We're going to answer that after the intro. So unfortunately, I don't have the exact file that Chaz is using, but I found an amphitheater on the SketchUp warehouse, and I put in this wall here, and I just wanted to show you something quick. This is a pretty simple tutorial. But I'd like to know what you guys would do. So let me know in the comments below how you would solve this problem, since it is a pretty beginner thing. So, but first I'm gonna make this a component. So I'm just gonna call this wall. And this amphitheater is in like a weird sort of orthogonal direction because I don't know why, but that's just why this shape looks so weird. So I'm gonna hit Q here to make a, to rotate this. Hit the up arrow here so I can lock to the blue axis while I'm rotating. And then what I might do actually is, I think this is gonna be symmetrical, but if the interior was maybe different, like a different material on the outside, I would probably flip this so that I could get different shapes. Now this is like a really bizarre shape. You probably wouldn't have these kind of walls on an amphitheater this size, but I'm going to show you two simple ways that you can get the angle that Chaz was looking for. So if you know the height, you can just draw a line down here. And it probably looks like there's nothing here. But this is endpoint, not midpoint. Hit M for the move tool. Or actually, I'm going to hit spacebar and then select this line. And then M for the move tool. And then you can actually move this in the vertical axis down to our point here. So that's like a pretty rough line. You probably actually want it so that it is the same slope as your steps. So I just hit L for the line tool and then drew that line and then hit M to move that line. So if I want to actually continue this so it goes to the edge, just trace along it and then hold shift so I'm locked in that. I can be in any sort of direction. Go past this, hit E for the eraser tool, and then P to push pull, and then E to erase that line. So you get a really nice low wall there. And both of them update because they are, as long as this amphitheater is built correctly, they are the same. Or I guess mirror images of each other. So those are the two ways that I would do this. Like I said, let me know in the comments below if you have any other ways that you might do this. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.